pouch across my body. This is not for fashion. This is not the playground. Ain't no fist fight, bitch. I'm blasting.
Yo, what is good, YouTube? It's your boy Rush, and today we back with a quick video. Now, this video today, I'm gonna just be talking about, you know, the possibility of this Kobe content. Now, I want to preface this by saying I do not have a guarantee that there is Kobe content. I'm just going off of what Ronnie2K said. You know, he is a primetime capper, but with everything that's being said, all the hype that's being built up, and tomorrow, which is April 13th, which was the day that he played his last game, it's looking pretty likely that we're going to get that Kobe content. Now, as Ronnie said in the video, he's going to be dropping after the tournament.
I was thinking about wearing this for the championship, because the next day we have Kobe content in 2K, and it might be a good tease towards that.
Devin Booker won the tournament last night, and it all just coincides to seem like now was the right time for them to drop that Kobe content. Now, I'm just making my speculations, and I'm going to give you guys the tips and tricks that I think will be beneficial to help you guys succeed, whether it be in getting Kobe or making MT when Kobe comes out. Now, also, with that being said, I am live on Twitch right now. As you're seeing this video, I am live on Twitch. Come hang out with your boy. If you got any questions, you just want to chop it up with me, link in the description, XRush TV. Follow me over there, because I cannot stream on YouTube at the moment. I'm like banned from streaming on YouTube. So, first thing I want to say is the first thing you want to do while getting ready for this Kobe content is make sure you put in locker codes. Always put in your locker code. You don't want to dilly-dally with that. Make sure you get your locker codes in time. I made a video about the new locker codes last night if you need to check them out. But, you know, if you pull something good, then you can have that. Second thing I would say, now this is in case Kobe is in packs. Now we don't know. This is really just speculative. But like you'll see Shaq's price is going down a little bit, but I mean no one's gonna stay at 1 million and that's not gonna happen, right? But just players that I've been looking at recently, Kevin Durant, I mean his price, he's looking at around 300K. I think people are actually selling their cards right now in preparation for this Kobe. So I was gonna say possibly sell your cards. Last night probably would have been a good time to sell your cards, but right now, depending on what these prices are, I'd monitor them throughout the day, and I'd probably hold on to your good cards. Because if the prices are this, the market might continue to crash a little bit. If he's in packs, if Kobe is in packs, the market will crash. Prices haven't changed that much, but it really depends. It really depends. Now, me, I sold all of my expensive cards. I think it's worth it to sell all your expensive cards right now, because if Kobe somehow does end up in packs, that is going to kill the market. That is going to crash the market. Dudes like T-Mac are going to lose value. Dudes in the shooting guard position are definitely going to lose value because people are going to be looking for them. So personally, I would say sell your Opal, sell your expensive cards right now, because it is a little bit more of a seller's market than it might be, because this KD still has 14 minutes left, so we could still end at like 400K. But the next thing that I think is going to be worth it, and I'll show you guys how far I am, is Spotlight Sim. Now, I'm looking at the tweet right now. I'll put it up on the screen for you guys as well. Ronnie said, got him yet? Trust me, you want him. And I think Two Bros Gaming on Twitter said something to the same level about that. So they're alluding to the fact that you're going to need this James Harden in some capacity. I know they updated his badges, but I don't think that's what it is. I think what they're going to do is a historic Spotlight Sim, but you need to have done the regular Spotlight Sim as a prerequisite to unlock it. You know what I'm saying? Like you need to do one of the dominations to unlock the next. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. So I would say, I mean, most of us, I mean, I'm a third of the way done. Most of us have not completed the whole thing. I'd say if you got time, knock it out. I mean, everybody's in the crib. Go ahead and knock these out. Try to get ahead as much as you can before tomorrow. Just, I mean, either way, you're going to be behind if you don't already have it. But you're going to want to knock out these for those challenges. But what goes hand in hand with knocking out these challenges is making sure that you have the players on the team. Now, I haven't been locking in collections this year in 2K. I don't particularly think collections are worth it. You see, I have enough MT to get Opals, and that's came from just doing the Spotlight Sim, getting those 6 tokens at the end, and playing Triple Threat Online. I do not think tokens are as valuable as they were in the past. But you'll see, I don't have players on every team, but this is just through opening packs. All of these players' prices today are pretty damn cheap. They are pretty damn cheap, and I think it would be better. So let's just look at a team that was in high demand last time, right? The Hawks. This Vince Carter card, 7,000 MT, probably not that much if we're being completely honest. 2,000 MT, 2,000. When the cards first came out, cards like this were going for 4,000 to 5,000 MT. If you guys have MT, now if you don't have a lot of MT, I don't suggest investing in these, because this investing, it could turn out good or it could turn out bad. It's just like a real stock market. You're investing in something and you don't really know what's going to happen. You see that the Vince Carter is 1,600 MT, which is not bad. You look at other players on the Hawks, 2,000 MT. I'm just looking at the Hawks per se because they were the most expensive and the team that was in the most demand. But in my opinion, if you have MT, like if you have MT like I have, I would consider going and investing in low-level bronze players on different teams. I mean, are there any bronze players actually in these teams there are. I know this team has a lot of players. So just Kobe, Simmons, whatever. If I were you, I would consider, I mean, you can just bid on that one, get them for 500 something. Consider investing in low level cards between bronze to probably gold. Now, once it gets to that sapphire ruby tier, those cards usually go, they don't go for that much. Their price might go up a little bit. But I would invest in those low-level bronze and silver and gold cards because they usually go for the cheapest. And once you get those cards, you can either A, hold on to them for when they possibly release a new spotlight sim. And then once they release that new spotlight sim, you'll be able to cash in and sell them to make a whole bunch of MT. Or you can just have the cards ready for when you're ready to do the Kobe challenges. Like you see, this dude's around. You know, he's not that expensive. Look at Willie Hernan Gomez. Once again, not that. I'm just looking through different players. Like I said, I would not really deal with the Sapphires and Emeralds. If you can catch Sapphires and Emeralds for cheap, cool. But in my opinion, I would probably go for those Silvers and Bronzes because the people are going to go for the lowest level player. People don't care about getting the good players for these challenges. They just care about getting the players so they can do the challenges. Like I said, I mean, I'll show you guys how far I've gone through in my Spotlight Sim. And like, I'm not sweating it. I'm just going through, doing it time by time. And I use that Quick Through STS playbook. That's another thing that I would suggest. The Nets playbook, like you said, I'm a third of the way done with the West. I could probably finish the West by the end of Monday if I really sweated. So I might try to get on my shit just so I can try to get the Kobe if he's there. Like I said, I do not have any guarantee that this is what's happening. We're just taking the word of Ronnie, which isn't always that reliable, but the whole community is piecing everything together and everybody thinks Kobe on Monday. It makes sense. His final game, all that stuff. So I don't know, man. It's really just all assumptions, but the last thing I want to say to you guys that I think you should scoop is this Nets playbook right here. This Nets playbook, whether you can get it on bid, where you can get it for cheap, it seems like every time solo challenges come out, people want to get the Nets playbook because that Quick Through STS play, it doesn't matter what players are using, you can beat the computer with this play because they don't know how to play it properly. Once again, if you're a budget baller, I don't suggest investing in this playbook unless you can snipe it for the low. Because if you buy it for $6,000 and then, you know, he comes out in packs and then his price goes up, or the price of the playbook goes down, then you've lost some MT, and I don't want to do that to y'all. Now, this I suggest that if you have more MT, consider investing in these playbooks. Because if it's around $5,000, if you get them for $5,000, once the challenges first come out, everybody trying to buy it up, you can sell it back for maybe $13,000, make a nice little profit. But if you're a budget baller, what I suggest you guys do is try to get those lower level cards. Try to get cards for cheap. And then once you get them for cheap, either hold on to them for challenges or sell them once the new stuff comes out. Like I said, you see the Nets playbook is hitting for around 5,000 MT. If you can get it for 5,000 MT, you're willing to hold on it. You're willing to take that risk. That's something I would suggest. But those are just some of the tips and tricks that I have for you guys in terms of getting these cards. Like I said, T-Max price is down a little bit. T-Max price, if Kobe does come out, will take the biggest hit in packs. His price will take the biggest hit just because he's another shooting guard, and a lot of people are going to rather have that Kobe than him. Like I said, you see Shaq's price is going down too. The market is still in a pretty good place though. Like this KD card, I would just monitor cards throughout the day. Right now it's 2 o'clock. Usually like to sell cards. I usually like to have my cards ending around 8 o'clock, so by around 4 o'clock, if you see that these prices are at a price where if you sell it you would feel comfortable getting that return on your card that you either purchased or packed, consider selling it, man. But those are just some things that I think can help you guys out in terms of getting this possible Kobe Bryant. Like I said, I have no guarantee that he's coming out, but I'll just reiterate them again. Put in your locker codes, knockout spotlight series if you got time. Look for cheap cards for each NBA team. It doesn't matter because I don't know which cards are going to be the best. Look for just cheap bronzes, silvers, and golds on each team and hold on to them because you can either make MT or you can use them for the challenges. And then monitor the market and see if you want to sell your cards. Those are the three things that I think are very prevalent that you can do right now that will help you make MT or get that Kobe Bryant tomorrow. If you guys have any ideas, any suggestions, any theories that you think about this Kobe content that could be coming out tomorrow, like I said, I don't know. Let me know in the comments below. Make sure you guys drop a like on the video. It really does help me out a lot. And hit the subscribe button as well. We're on the road to 20K. And with all that being said, I hope you guys have a blessed one. I'll catch y'all later, man. Peace.